Well, nobody's perfect, but this penguin is certainly a box of surprises. It brings also good news for those who suffer the cold. Yes, we are close to November and Halloween. Let's now again see a video on the astonishing heat pump. Hello, dear energy do-it-yourselfers, and welcome to a new video again about heat pumps. Today we are talking about a household device that really surprises me. The air conditioner Perfetto, a kind of wonder penguin with 1,001 functions. Tell me if you have something similar in your country. Introduction to the Perfetto. I recently bought two Perfetto air conditioners at a shopping center in the province of Catania in Sicily. On the box it says cooling only. But I assure you that this is not all. This unit has more functions than indicated on the box. And today I'm here to show them to you. In Italy, we speak of a penguin, indicating the mobile air conditioner with a proboscis that blows warm air out. But if it has also the winter function, it will blow out the cold air. The Perfetto also looks like a penguin, but a rather large one. I would almost call it the emperor penguin. Why is it so big and what makes it different? Distinguishing the Perfetto from conventional mobile air conditioners. The Perfetto is not an ordinary penguin that cools the air and throws out the warm air through a tube. No, this device works differently, using a thermal energy storage system. This does away with the big tube for the hot or the cold air that forces us to pierce the wall or glass. You see a traditional penguin here, at least the skin. The inside is now in my test TES project of the previous video. In Sicily, they call me indeed Squarcia Pinguino, or a penguin butcher, hot and cold in one appliance. I discovered that it can not only cool the room, this limitation is displayed on the box, it can also produce heat. Let me focus on that, because winter is coming. Heating can be done in two ways. According to the instructions, he can do it with heat accumulation, previously loaded during the store heat function, with a resistor of 1100 watt in the 37 liter water tank. When then put into the heat mode, it will use the heat pump of about 700 watt to bring probably about 3 kilowatt into the room. Of course, this will cool down the water tank, but at the same time, I think the resistor will heat it up with 600 watt, because I measure a total power for the resistor and the heat pump of 1400 watt. So in short, this device is able to give high power to quickly heat up a room that is cold, but the absorbed power remains always under 1400 watt. That is a modest power. A second, somewhat more hidden method that I prefer occurs during the cold storage mode, using the heat pump. While it accumulates cold heat in the 37 liter water tank, it releases a considerable amount of heat into your home. Remember, the heat pump has always a cold and a hot side. The instructions say then to open all the windows, as I certainly advise in summer. However, in winter, I use this mode by closing the windows tightly. I can later put the penguin on the balcony to get rid of the cold. This method is also perfect in situations where you need to alternate between hot and cold, for example in mid-season, as now. What also is not described is that heat can be stored not only with a resistor of 1100 watt, like above under point A, but by using the heat pump itself. Seems rational, right? Indeed, during the mode cooling or strong cooling, the documentation tells that it will dump the heat into the water tank, heating it up even up to 50 degrees Celsius. That process can be done by pushing the device onto the balcony or another place of little concern and let it store heat before you need it. Still another way, quick but a little bit cumbersome, is to drain the cold water. You can use it to flush the toilet 4 times and fill it with another 37 liter of water from the water grid at about 15 degrees Celsius. Draining and filling is an automatic process with an internal pump and a valve. Now, how much energy is in 37 liters of water? With the formula K times M times delta T, or a constant, the heat capacity constant, times the mass, or the amount of liters, times the delta T, let's put it at 23 degrees, you come at this value, and then dividing it by 3600 for the conversion to kilowatt hours, you get only 1 kilowatt hour. But on the box is written 3.5 kilowatt hour of storage, and that certainly is because they can go down to minus 6 degrees, forming an ice bank. Because freezing water is equivalent to heating it up by 80 degrees, the same formula gives 4.18 times 80 degrees times 37 liters divided by 3600 is 3.4 kilowatt hours, which added to the 1 kilowatt hour gives 4.4 kilowatt hours, so that more or less seems right. The option that seems most attractive to me for heating at a low energy cost is the function store cold, because that heats with the heat pump and without the resistor. I have to try a few things with this wonder box, and the temptation is there to open up this penguin too, like the other penguins that I opened already for the previous heat pump videos. I guess it is better to visit the inventors in Italy and interview them together with you, my appreciated audience. I will let you know. Quiet operation and no exhaust hose. Quiet operation is possible because of its operation in two stages. Stage 1. Use the cold stored in the tank during operation 2B as above. In this phase, while it consumes the cold in the tank, there is no compressor noise as it blows the cold with an adjustable breeze. Very quiet, so you can sleep soundly. The second advantage of this operation mode is that the cold is supplied without simultaneous production of heat. That has been done during the cold storage phase. So you don't need a big hose, and you don't need to make a hole in wool or glass. Step 2. When the cold storage is exhausted and the water becomes 18 degrees Celsius, the heat pump starts up. Talking about noise, I perceive the heat pump as quiet. It generates additional cold by discharging the heat into the 37 liter water tank, up to 50 degrees Celsius, as they say. The indication of high temperature. And now I find this quite interesting as a winter application: energy efficiency and silence. The Perfetto consumes an average of 300 watts, according to the producer. That depends obviously on the speed of discharge of the cooling energy. In addition, it is extremely quiet in the first phase of the cooling, just 21 decibel. It's practically imperceptible, so you can use it in the summer while sleeping. With heating, it's noiseless during heat storage, 1100 watts with a resistor. During the release, with the heat pump and the fan active, it makes a bit of noise with the heat pump and a variable noise level with the fan, depending on its speed. We are here at a power absorption of 1400 watts. A versatile and innovative product. The wide range of possible uses of this device surprised me. With just one device, it's possible to cool, to heat, to dehumidify, without the needs for pipes, hoses, or external drains. Heat pump technology is exploited here in every possible way. For an engineer or heating technician, it's truly fascinating. It's a real wonder box. I'm very tempted to make one myself with another second-hand penguin. Like this. What was that? A big container of water and wheels thereunder. The price is also interesting. At 400 euros, it's yours. Go to the link in the description. That's as much as the more expensive models of the normal Penguin. And no, I have no financial relationship with the producer on this moment. I'm just client. The most surprising is that this device is already 4 years on the market and on YouTube. One of those interesting inventions which have not been understood by the broad market. But for us, energy do-it-yourselfers is certainly a fascinating thing. It gives us more flexibility than all the standard products which are offered by tens of different suppliers. Let's take a closer look to this device in less than a minute and start to discover its functions. But first, I want to tell you why I run this channel and what you can gain by joining this community of energy home do-it-yourself. First, I ask you for your patience. I did not have time to finish today the promised video, as said in video 69, on the thermal energy storage for central heating in the house. But I promise to do so more calmly in the next weekend. As this is currently an unpaid activity that I am passionate about, I have to supplement my living cost with other activities. And if the opportunity of a big fish arises, as it did next week, I will jump into the water as a penguin. If you want me to devote full time to this channel, to energy and to the climate, I ask you to subscribe and to share this video with your friends. During the 18 months that I already dedicate to this channel, I have never had a lack of fascinating ideas, so I can continue to offer much more to my dear viewers for many years to come. That will help you to keep control of the energy situation in your home, be it energy saving or production, saving money or ensure energy supply during a blackout. So let's now take a close look to the emperor under the penguins. We switch it on. Then we go to the two storages. This is the cool storage. And it will now store the cold in the tank, and it will also start the heat pump. It's now taking 550 volts. Then we go to the heat storage. The cold storage and also the heat storage displayed the temperature of the tank. So it's 37 degrees. Of the experiment of yesterday, because with heat storage it cannot go more than 30 degrees. That was it for today. And as always, if you have comments or questions, leave them in the comments below. In particular, let me know if you have this device in your country. Thank you for your support and see you in the next video. That one will definitely be about connecting the radiators of your home to the thermal energy storage.